day. This is Dwayne Coos with another Digilog Recorry historical weather update. I'm here today on the Sauk River just after the coming of the month of April in the year 2007. Over this past weekend, we had probably somewhere between 2 and 3 inches of rain that fell on the Sauk River watershed district. And I'm here today at the dam that's right next to the Granite Company in downtown Cold Spring, just to show you how much water is flowing in the river at this time. And of course, because the rain fell yesterday, most likely the water will continue down that watershed. It usually takes a day to 2 days to eventually get to this point here. So we probably will see the water rise versus fall in terms of what I'm showing you right now. It's the background of this rising water that brings us today to talk about a story that takes us back to 1964, when you'll see that the water was right up to the bottom, right up to the very, very bottom of this railroad bridge. A story that's told to us by Herb and Lorraine Hesse.
We moved in 64, and that was the year when we had no snow. I believe it was reported the ice on the river was 48 inches thick because it was a bitter, bitter winter. And without snow, we had really some very thick ice. And then in March, I believe it was in the middle of the week, we had a 18-inch snowstorm, followed by 1 week later, a second one of another 18 inches. So we had 36 inches of snow on that heavy ice. And then we had a sort of a rapid thaw, and it caused flooding, the floods of 1965. So we had to move some of the mobile homes that were down by the riverbank. We had to move them out as the water was rising. And we had to put up a barricade around our house because they said it was going to come up another 2 feet, and it would have really inundated our basement. So we had the local dray line, Albert Kramer, haul in some fill, and we threw a dike around the house, and we dug a hole in the ground so we could put in a pump and pump the water back over the dike as fast as it would come in, you know.
Our basement was completely finished when, and so we had several bedrooms downstairs, so we had to evacuate. I mean, we had to protect our property, and we'd put the washer and dryer up on blocks and everything else down there that we could possibly put up on blocks, we did, because we didn't know where the water was going to come from. We have pictures of some of the children rowing boats right up to the back door because of the high water at that time.
And so we did have some leakage in the basement because the ice, the thick ice, was jamming up against the bridge over here on County Road 2, and in order to save the bridge and whatever else, they had to dynamite the ice. And every time a blast of dynamite would go off, our house would shake and the water would come seeping through the joints in the basement. So we did have some water in the basement, but it was only of a quantity that you could almost wipe up with a rag and a pail, because we were constantly pumping it back over the dike. And we won that battle.